C++ Debugging in TRACE32 PowerView. This video describes the TRACE32 PowerView commands and approaches that can be helpful for C++ debugging. We use a TRACE32 PowerView for ARM release of September 2018 together with the PowerDebug USB3 connected to a TIOMAP4430 which has two Cortex-A9 cores. I have here a C++ demo code running on the first Cortex-A9 core. The varwatch and varview commands can be used to show the content of instances of structures and classes. I will display, for example, here the content of the wood class instance WPTR by doing a right mouse click on the object name within the list window and select View in Window. The wood structure is inherited from the tree structure. You can see this by doing a right mouse click on the type name and select Other, View Info. Using the symbol class command, you can additionally display the class hierarchy in a tree view. By doing a right mouse click on the symbol name in the var view window, then selecting Format, you can open a dialog with various display settings. The following four display options can be useful for C++ debugging. The inherited checkbox, which is selected here per default, controls whether anything is displayed from the base classes. I will deselect this option and hit Apply. The information from the base class tree is then not displayed anymore. With the inherited name option, you can select if the name or the base class is displayed in front of the inherited elements. With the methods checkbox, you can choose if you want to show all known methods of the class. Let's now have a look at the following class instance. The hidden checkbox controls whether artificially created symbols are visible. I will enable the hidden option. You can see there is a new element in the var view window, which is a pointer of the virtual method table. I will additionally display the methods. By the context menu display memory, then and direct dump, we can dump the virtual method table. By doing a right mouse click on the first value in the virtual method table and selecting display memory, then and direct list, I can display the source code of the vfun method, which is the first virtual method of the class in the virtual method table. Generic algorithms use the polymorphic nature of classes they work with. These algorithms will handle pointers to objects that fulfill an interface or are derived from a certain parent class. The most derived class is the class type that was used to create a particular instance. By default, the variable displaying windows will treat these pointers with the type that is used in the current context. The derived option can be turned on for a certain entry of the variable window by double-clicking the tree node icon, or using the context menu. In contrast to C, multiple functions can have the same name by using the overloading technique. The functions must then differ in their parameter signatures. In C++ object files, therefore, an exported symbol is encoded using function name and parameter signature into one mangled name. The mangling can be different for different compilers. TRACE32 demangles the names controlled by the command symbol demangle. I will type that command in the TRACE32 command line and press F1 to open the documentation. The first parameter sets whether the demangle is turned on. The second parameter controls if the parameter signature is concatenated to the symbol name. This is all I wanted to show you in this video. Please refer for more details to the application note C++ debugging. Thank you for watching.